Hi, my name is Amanda Cook, and I'm a PhD candidate here at the Dunlap Institute. Well, no, because we don't even know all the stars out there. But every star that's been detected by an astronomer has a name. The name of the star typically tells us something about it. There are some stars which are just so well known and so bright in the sky that we've known about them for centuries, in which case we're gonna have a common nickname like Vela or Deneb. But there are 100 billion stars just in the Milky Way, so we can't name them all cute names like that. Most of them are just some combination of letters and numbers that might tell us who detected it, what telescope detected it, where it is in the sky, or when we detected it. Not really. It's not like I can go discover a star and call it Amanda. Most fields in astronomy have naming conventions. However, if you detect a new type of star or a new phenomenon, you might get to name it after yourself for a little while, just while they find out a better scientific name to call it. Companies know that space is super cool and that we all love space, and they're trying to capitalize on it. Who wouldn't want to be a part of something bigger in the universe? But what you really buy when you buy the naming rights to a star is just a line in some company's database that says you own it, or a piece of paper, at best. These companies don't have a way to tell astronomers, though, that they've changed the name. And even if they did, it would be so confusing, because the names, as I said earlier, have a little bit of information about the star. They can tell us which system it's in, and we would lose that information if we changed the name. If you're looking for a cool space-themed gift to give somebody, it's better to support your local astronomy initiatives. You can visit a planetarium, go to a nearby observatory, or you can just buy a grad student a cup of coffee.